Today, I'm going to introduce you to a new video generation model called SVI Pro. Now, this isn't exactly a brand new model from scratch. It has gone through several versions like WAN 2.1 and WAN 2.2. But today, we are specifically looking at the SVI Pro version. So why was this Pro version released? Well, the SVI in WAN 2.2 actually had a fatal flaw. What was that flaw? Let's take a look. In this workflow, we are using the standard WAN 2.2, so we note that this is not the Pro version. We have a reference image here of a beautiful woman and a horse. If we generate a video from this, let's see what happens. Look closely. You might not catch it at first glance, but I'll tell you the answer. There is a glitchy loop happening. Did you notice the horse jumps twice? If that wasn't clear enough, let's generate another video. This time the reference image is a woman kneeling in the snow. My prompt is asking her to run. Let's look at the result. Pay attention to her movement. She's about to stand up, but then she kneels back down, right? She basically returns to her original state. This is what we call an action loop. The new SVI Pro model mainly focuses on fixing this by improving video extension. So we are going to focus on showing you three types of workflows today. The first one is extending an existing video. For example, I have a video here and I can use SVI Pro to extend it. As you can see, the extension effect is actually quite impressive. The second workflow is a bit more powerful. We start with just a single image. We use SVI Pro to generate a video segment first, and then we sequentially extend it. The final workflow allows us to generate a video and then extend it infinitely. For instance, here I've extended it 3 times after the initial generation. Let's look at the final result. Hey, look at that. It's also very impressive. I've built these workflows on Running Hub, so you can access the platform through there in the ComfyUI space. Running Hub is a fantastic online workspace because whenever there are new models or technologies, they follow up and update immediately. You can use the invitation link in my video description to register for Running Hub, which will get you 1,000 free points. Plus, you get 100 gifted points every day just for logging in, so you can try out your own workflows. Now, let's understand the mechanics behind SVI. You can open its GitHub page. There's a link here explaining the SVI 2.0 Pro architecture. If you click on it, you'll see they made improvements in essentially 3 areas. First, anchor point resetting. The anchor point here refers to the anchor frame, which you can simply think of as our reference image. Second, latent conditioning. This is mainly to avoid repetitive encoding and decoding. Third, data scaling to improve robustness. Notice that everything here is referred to as latent. There is no images mentioned. SVI Pro primarily processes content within the latent space, not the actual pixels of an image. There's a diagram below that explains this. The anchor frame is basically our reference image after VAE encoding, turning it into latent content. This content is shared throughout the entire video extension process. So you'll find that this anchor frame exists in every clip. Then there is another crucial concept, the last frame of the previous segment, which we call the last latent. Think of this as the final frame of the previous video, Virginia E encoded, which guides the motion for the next video generation. Again, remember the principle, no images appear in SVI Pro. All operations happen in latent space. Also, there's a very important line here. The anchor frame mechanism is designed to resolve conflicts with a light X to V acceleration LoRa. This tells us that in our workflow, we must use the light X to V acceleration LoRa. Let's look at the first workflow, extending an existing video. The overall structure is just a WAN 2.2 image to video workflow. Let's run through it quickly. Here is our source video. We resize it first to match our resolution. We extract the first frame. I'll call this the raw image end. The entire video content we call the last image. Next is model loading. This applies the knowledge we just talked about. The acceleration model we use here must be light X to V. Why? Because there are 2 versions of acceleration models, lightning and light X to V. If you use lightning, it tends to be unstable. The available light X to V models are limited. For the high noise model, I'm using the 1030 version because it is light X to V. Many other acceleration models you see are lightning versions, so try to avoid those. For the low noise model, I'm using a traditional light X to V acceleration model provided by Kijibe. Here, we use two very important models, the SVI Pro models. Kijai uploaded links to these new models on Hugging Face just 2 days ago. Our prompt is, a beauty puts down her wine glass and stands up. Now look at the latent space generation section. There is a node replacement here. Usually we use the standard node, but for SVI Pro, we must switch to this specific node. Where do you get it? It's inside KJ Nodes. KJ Nodes is another essential extension by Kijai. You need to update it to the latest version to get this node. This node is interesting. Besides positive and negative conditioning, it has two key inputs. First, the anchor frame, but remember it's a latent. So I take the first frame of my video, VAE encoded, and connect it here. Below that is previous samples. Referring back to the diagram, the anchor frame is the blue part, and previous samples refers to the video clip generated in the last sampling again in latent form. So I take my entire video, VAE encoded, and connect it here. We can set the length for the next generated video. There is also a crucial setting called motion latent count. This means how many frames from the previous samples will be used to guide the next video generation. The default is E. When setting this, make sure the number of frames you provide is larger than the number you write here, or it will error out. We get new conditions and new latents. Then we move to sampling. This is the same high-gen noise and low-gen noise sampling as the traditional one RIV, so I won't go into detail there. After sampling, we need to stitch the video. We use another KJ node for this. The most important setting here is overlap. Since video extensions often have overlapping frames, we set the overlap here, let's say to Wu, to make the generated video effect much smoother. That covers the first workflow. The core of this workflow really is that SVI Pro node. The second workflow is slightly more complex. It has two parts, generation and extension. First, the generation part. We start with a reference image, resized to 832x480. The model selection is identical to what I described before. Our prompt is a beauty elegantly tasting red wine. We use that same SVI node, but with a difference, we don't have previous samples yet. If you want to be technical, you can set the value to 0, but frankly, if you don't connect anything there, it doesn't matter. Everything else remains the same as the previous workflow. After sampling, we generate the first space video. Let's look. The girl is tasting wine. This is a typical image-to-video workflow using SVI Pro. Then we move to the extension phase. The mechanism is exactly the same as the first video extension workflow we discussed. The core node is still the same. This time, previous samples connects to the video we just generated. The anchor frame is shared, so it's still the reference image. After merging the two videos, we get a nice result. Since my second prompt focused on the girl standing up, you can see that action clearly. This workflow is great for understanding how to generate and then extend. But the downside is it only does two segments and stitches them. Can we go infinitely? Yes, absolutely. That leads us to the third workflow. The mechanism is exactly the same as the second one, except I've added a loop. I connected the latent generated from the last round to initial value 1, and the generated video to initial value 2. I have a prompt list providing 3 different prompts again. We don't want every prompt to be the same. Since I have 3 prompts, I set the loop to cycle 3 times. I control the start index to pick the prompt I want. The body of the loop is the same as the video extension logic we just covered. The only thing to watch is that specific node. The anchor frame remains constant. The reference image. The key is previous samples. The previously generated video. In this loop, we always fetch this from value 1. After encoding, we do 2 things. Connect the newly generated samples back to initial value 1 so that next time it grabs the new latent. Connect the generated video to initial value 2 to facilitate the final stitching. After 3 cycles, we get the final video. Let's look at it. The new movements are very rich. I can't say it perfectly followed every prompt though. Let's review the prompts. Girl puts down glass and stands up. She smiles and waves hello. This action didn't really happen. She leaves the room. Let's watch the result. She starts tasting wine, then stands up. No waving action, but then the final key action happens. She leaves the room. Overall, I think the performance is quite good. Notice that the transitions between the three segments are very smooth. No color shifting, no ghosting artifacts. I think the new SVI Pro model is definitely worth trying. In these workflows, the most common mistake people make is choosing the wrong LoRa. If the LoRa isn't right, your prompts might not manifest in the video at all. I strongly suggest you choose the Light X to V LoRa and avoid the Lightning LoRa. Alright, that's all for today. What are you waiting for? Go try it out yourself. Don't forget to subscribe to become an AI expert.